Welcome to Nagesh Karazki Orchid School Channel. Myself, Priscilla Asade. I am going to teach you English grammar of grade 4. Students, what we have finished in last session of grammar? Yes, we have finished with lesson number 14, that is articles A, An, and The. Today, we are going to start with a new lesson, that is lesson number 15, Verbs. Now, just tell me students, what is verbs? Can you tell me what is verbs? Yes, verbs is nothing but a doing words. Now for example, can you tell me any doing words, or you can say action words? Now for example, now I am teaching you grammar, okay? So I am teaching, my process is that going on, doing, that is an action word, okay? So some more examples you can say, that is eating, then you can say playing, again you can say yes, dancing, jumping, still more example, skipping, reading and writing. Means whenever you are doing this process, some action has been done. So whatever action is going on in a person, animal, place or thing, so that is eating, playing, dancing, jumping, skipping, reading, writing, that is a verb. This we are going to see in today's lesson. Not only this, verbs means still what is there in that, what we are going to learn, that whatever a person, place, animal or thing is, for example, is a, okay. So for example, Reena is a good girl, okay. If I say Reena is a good girl, Reena is a clever girl, whatever a person is, so that also includes in verbs. This is the second thing which we are going to learn. Again, whatever person, place, animal or thing has, means whatever it possesses, belongs to them, okay. In this we are going to see some examples. In this has also we are going to see some examples. Now for example, in this what we are going to see, a person, place, animal or thing has. For example, Reena is a good girl. Reena has a long beautiful hair. This is a thing which she possesses, okay. This also comes under verbs. Understood, sir? So in these verbs, not only action words or doing words are included, but whatever a person, place, animal or thing is. For example, Reena is a good girl, okay. And the third thing what we are going to learn is, when the verb, in the verbs, a person, place, animal or thing has means belongs or whatever it possesses, okay. For example, Reena has a long beautiful hair. This is a thing which belongs to Reena. So these are the three things which we are going to learn in today's lesson, that is lesson number 15, verbs. So what you are going to do, students? Yes, you have to open Fun with Grammar book, lesson number 15. Take pencil in your hand. Whatever explanation are there, according to that I'll teach you, and then we are going to solve examples. So take pencil, eraser in your hand. So very easy lesson, only you have to just pay attention. Ready? Okay, so come on page number 44, lesson number 15. Can you see here? Yes, what is this? Lesson number 15, verbs. Now here are some sentences they have given below. For example, Meena goes to school every day. Birds fly in the sky. babies cry when they are hungry. Again, will you repeat, students, along with me the given sentences? Yes. Meena goes to school every day. Birds fly in the sky. Babies cry when they are hungry. Now, in this, can you see these three words are bold? Yes. So, these words, that is goes, fly and cry. What are they? Yes. They are doing words and they tell us what Meena, birds and babies do. So, they are called verbs. Understood, students? Again, do you want me to repeat? Again, I'll say, can you see in these three sentences, goes, fly and cry? This shows what the noun, that is Meena, birds and baby, they are doing. Okay, they are doing words. So, they are called verbs. Now, we'll see the definition of verb. Okay, make it a star. And you know for what we are doing star? Yes, we have to learn this definition. Now, what is verb? The word, this word, okay? The word which tells us what a person, animal or thing does. What it? Again, I'll say, the word which tells us what a person, animal or thing does is known as a doing word or verb. Understood with the definitions? Okay. Now, in each sentence, you will get a verb. Without verb, it is not possible to form a sentence. Else, it will be an incomplete sentence or meaningless sentence. Understood? Now, in this exercise, now what we are going to do? Yes, we are going to solve the exercise. It is very easy. Only you have to underline the verbs in these sentences. You have to recognize which is the doing word, which is the action word, and that you have to underline it. Are you ready, students? I hope that you are having pencil along with me. And you can do before me also, else you can just pay attention if you have not understood. Again, I will explain you with different examples. Ready, students? Okay, what is exercise A? Underline the verbs in these sentences. First, eat your breakfast quickly. Now tell me, which is the action word here? Very good. That is eat. I am going to underline eat. That is a verb. Eat means like this, we are eating. Yes or no? So that is the action word. Now second, my sister sings well. Yes, sings. Sings means singing is a part of the action word. So, sings. Got it? How we are doing? What is the verb? Next, the dog barks at night. What is the verb? Yes, bark. Barking. The dog barks at night. Yes or no? So, barking is what? Action word. Children play in the park. Now play is what? The children are playing in the park. So play is a action word. I swim in the evening. Yes. Swim. Swim is also a verb. Meena draws picture. She is drawing picture. So drawing is also a action word. Father drives a car. Drive. Grandma walks in the morning. See, when you are reading the sentence, try to imagine the sentence in your mind. Then you will come to know what is the action going on. Now, grandma walks means she is walking. So, walking is the action word. Fatima often helps me in the kitchen. So, helps. The lion roars. Yes, when it is angry. I hope that you have done along with me the given verbs. Okay, done. So, here we have finished with the doing verbs, that is verb. Now, what is the next thing we are going to learn, students? Yes. Verbs tells us what a person, place, animal or thing is. Ready? Done with this all the 10 examples? Okay, so we will move forward to the same page. Now, here we have seen only the action words or doing words. Now, you can see here, am, is, are. We are going to learn something more about am, is and are. Now, read these sentences. What is the three sentences given? Come on, read. Yes. I am a dancer. Now, keep in your mind, am always come with the word I, with the subject I. Am never comes with any of the subject. Always am comes with the subject am. So, please keep in your mind. Next. The dog is very active. Now, here we can see here what which verb is used. IS, is. Okay. So, is used with the singular, that is the dog. The chairs are new. Now, here we can see chairs. It is a plural. So, we have used are. Now, we will see why this am, is, are is used and how it is used. We'll see or we'll come on to the next page, that is page number 45. Okay. Now, here, whatever words were bold, what was that? Am, is and are. What it tells? It tells us what I am or the dog is or what the chairs are. They do not tell us what I, the dog and the chair are doing. Got it? So, the second thing which we are going to learn or which we are learning is that what a person, animal or thing is. So, in the first sentence, if you will see, it shows that what I am. Yes, what I am? Yes, I am a dancer. The second sentence, the dog is very active. It shows how the dog is. Yes or no? So, dog is very active. And the non-living thing, it is telling chairs. So, how are the chairs? Yes, the chairs are new. So, these all the three sentences does not show what they are doing. It shows what they are or what they. Okay. So, am, is and are also called verb. Just underline these verbs, students. But it, now, other similar verbs are was, were, shall be, will be and so on. Okay. These are for the present tense. These are for all past tense and future tense. So, underline this verb. Am, is, are. They are verbs. Not only that, we are going to underline was, were, shall be, will be and so on. Okay. Now, just make it a star. So, second thing what we have learned, verb also tells us what a person, animal or thing is. Got it? So, whatever I am telling you to underline or circle, whatever is there, just do it in your book so that whenever you are going to learn, that will help you. Why teacher has told you to underline. Understood, students? About the second thing what we have learned, that what a person, animal or thing is? Yes. Now, depending on this, we are going to solve exercise B. Ready? Okay. Underline the verbs in the following sentence. B also tells us only you have to underline the verb. So, what we have learned? Am, is, are, was, were, will be and shall be. Now, only that things you are going to underline. You have to just bahar that words. And now only you have to pick up that words. Because it tells us what a person, animal or thing he is. In these we are not going to underline the doing words or action words. Okay, first. Now, Monica is a good girl. Now, how is Monica? Yes, she is a good girl. So, is a verb. Next, Meena and Veena. Now, here we can see two girls are there. So, they have used are. Okay. The dress is gorgeous. The dress is gorgeous. Is yes, verb. The baby is hungry. I will be little fast. It is very easy. Sachin is a good batsman. How is Sachin? Yes, he is a good batsman. Now about the trees. The trees in the garden. What they are telling? Whatever trees are there.
How are they?
Yes, they are tall.
I have told you before only, along with the I subject always am comes. Which verb comes? Am. So I am a student of class 3rd. Elephants are large animals.
Yes, are.
Deer are timid animals.
Are.
Bina is my classmate. Now here in all these 10 examples only they have given am, is and are, and so it was very easy to underline the verbs. Understood, student? Okay, next, shall we move, students? It is only a point of doing underlying. I hope that you have done it. Chalo. Next is has and have. Now what is the third thing we are going to learn? Can you tell me? In introduction part I have told you three things we are going to learn. And now what is the third part?
Yes, verbs tells us about a person, place, animal or thing. What a person, place, animal or thing has or possesses.
We'll move on to the same page. Okay, page number 45. Ready? Has and have. Now you have to read the given sentences. Mona has a new pen. Can you see that girl is having a pen? Miss, that pen is of whose? That pen is belonging to whom? Mona. And we have a new pet. New pet is with whom? With us. So that new pet belongs to us. So this has and have, what they are showing? What we possess or what, which thing belongs to us. Now see here, the words has, have, what it tells us? What Mona and we have or possesses. They do not tell us what Mona and we are doing. Now here also what we are going to see, here the verbs does not show what they are doing, which action they are doing, but it shows what a person, place, animal or thing possesses or they have. Now can you see this pen, black marker? Yes, it is of whom? It is of mine. So it belongs to me. Okay, so in the same way we can see whatever things belongs to any person, place, an animal or thing, that comes under verb only. Now what are the verbs they have included? Has and have. Have you underlined this has and have? You underline have or possesses. Okay, now has, have are also called verbs. Okay, as we have seen, am, is, are, was, were, will be, shall be, all comes under the verbs. Same way has and have also comes under verbs. Had is another verb of the same time. Here again they have told had is also another verb of the same time. Now here you make it a star. Verbs also tells us what a person, animal or thing has or possesses. Understood, students? What is the third thing we are learning? Yes, has or possesses. Got it? Everyone, with a given example, whatever I have explained. Okay, now shall we move on to the exercise? Have you done all the underlined part, whatever I have told, and this you make it a star to? Yes, to bahat it. See, all the definition you should bahat in the grammar part, because definition is the thing which will help you to understand what is there in that topic. Okay, and whenever you are learning definition, you have to learn it with one example. Now we will solve the example. We are going to solve exercise C on the same page, that is 45. Ready? Yes. Here also, only what you have to do, underline the verbs in these sentences. In the first exercise A, what we have done? We have underlined the verbs, which are action words or doing words. In the second, what we have done, am, is, are. In that, whatever person, place, animal or thing is,
Okay. Now here, what we are going to do? We are going to underline the person that tells us what a person, animal, or thing has or possesses. Ready, students? Okay. Now see. Tanu has long hair. So three words you have to just keep in your mind. Has, have, and had. So just what do you have to do? I'll read the sentence and then pick out the verbs. Tanu has long hair. Now what Tanu is having? Yes, long hair belongs to whom? Tanu. So has. What is it? The doll has pretty eyes. Doll is there and how its eyes is? Yes, very pretty. So HAS has. Now you should make it a habit that you have to read the sentence and then only you have to pick out the verbs. Blindly don't do it anything. Now you move on to page 46. I hope that you have underlined the two examples. Okay. Okay. The children have new toys. What the children are having? Yes, they are having new toys. Have is a verb. Monali has a new dress. So whose dress that is? Monali's. So that new dress belongs to whom? Monali. So has shows the thing that belongs to her. Vani and Manu have a new friend. Have. The room has many windows. The book has interesting story. The spider has 8 legs. Yes. We have a holiday tomorrow. He has a little sister. I hope that you have understood what we have done in the last part. Okay. Has, have, and had. Only here they have given has and have. Done, students? Okay. Ready? We'll move on to next. Something more about verbs we are going to learn. Now, till now, what we have learned, students? How many verbs we have underlined? Only a single verb. Now, in the next thing, you will come to know that verbs is not only of one word, but it also consists of more than one word. Now, how it is? Now, look here. What they have told? We have learned about verbs which have only one word. For example, we have seen whatever action words or doing words were there. And the next part we have seen am, is, are, was, were, will be, shall be. And then the third part we have done has, have, and had. So, till here what they have told that we have learned that verbs have only one word. Now, let us read some sentences. They are telling that now, whatever we are going to learn some sentences, the verb is made up of more than one word. Now, how it is, we'll see in these examples. Can you see the examples, sentences? They are telling, read the sentences. Abhi is playing in the park. Now, here you can see, is, is also there and action doing verb is also there. So, verb is playing is made up of two words. And then the second is the train will be reaching the station at 4 p.m. This sentence tells us about the future tense. So, 1, 2, will be reaching. Can you see? Yes, 1, 2 and 3 words. More than one word. Got it? Here we can see two other. Got it? In this part, what we have learned? That verbs is not only made of one word, but it can be of more than one. That is 2 or 3. Got it? Understood? Only that much is there. Now we are going to solve exercise D. And now when we are going to solve exercise D, you have to keep in your mind that when we are underlying the verbs, it should be of, we should read the sentence, we should find out how many verbs are there, and according to that we have to underline.
Shall I start, students, with exercise D? Underline the verbs in the following sentence. The, how many are there? 12 examples are there. I will only solve 6 examples. Remaining you have to do as a homework. Ready? The stars are shining in the sky. Now tell me, what are the verbs over here? Yes, are shining. So how many verbs are there here? 2 verbs are there. We are doing our homework. Yes, after the subject itself, are doing. Vinit and Vishal, here 2 persons are there, are reading books. Okay, next. My grandmother is walking in the, yes, is walking. You can see is there. I am feeling hungry. I have told you before only with I, which verb goes am. The baby is crying. Here if you see, all the verb is having ing words. Okay, so the remaining 7 to 12, make it as a homework. I think it is very easy. Within a minute you can underline that. Understood? Here we can see is ringing. Here 3 are there, will be arriving, have called, has found, have, and are marching. Done? Okay, now we'll move on to exercise 47. As this is only we are underlining, we'll move on to the next. I hope that you'll do it as a homework. It is not too hard. Okay, next. Now, here in the E, what they have told you to do? Okay, we'll take this. Here, what they have told, can you see the picture? There are some actions they are doing. Okay, so what you have to do? You have to fill in the blanks with the help of the given words given in the grid or given in this box. Can you see? Tells us what they are doing with the help of the words given in the box below. See, they have shown you the picture also and they have given some example also, and I hope that that is very easy. Okay, so make it as a homework. For example, I'll tell you the voice. What they are doing, students? Can you see the picture? Yes, they are playing. And now just keep in your mind, whenever it is plural, so that time you are going to write are. And whenever it is singular, that time you are going to use is. Now the boys, what they are doing? Are playing. And there is no need for you also for these helpful words. Yes or no? You can make out. Still they have given, you can write. The boys are playing. Jyoti and Ragini, yes, they are dancing. Now here, Susan. Can you see? Here third one, she is alone. Single. So I am going to use is cutting. Got it? Chalo, write this first. Done? Okay. Now we'll move on to the last page. Okay. In the last page, what they have told, we have to fill in the blanks with the words from the box. Here also they have given some helpful words for you to fill in these blanks. Now you have to read that sentence. The boys dash in the garden. Now what will come? Yes, it is, yes, what is this? So, plural. So boys play in the garden. First, Mohini is dash. What Mohini is there? Nothing, picture is given. You have to make it out. Mohini is singing. I'll just put the numbers. Third, I always dash to school. That is, I always walk to school. I am just giving the number, you afterwards put it in the blanks. Fourth, I have dashed my dinner already. I have, what will come? Eaten. Fourth, the washerwoman wash our clothes. This is fifth. The baby was dashed when it saw me. Yes, what the baby does when it sees any other person? They smile. Rohan is dash a picture. What he is drawing? Yes, he is drawing a picture. 8. I dash my homework on time. Yes, I do my homework on time. The girls are dash outside. They are sketching. Next, we will dash the ground at 10 a.m. So, what is the answer? 10th. We will reach. Raj dash his father to wash the car. What Raj is doing? He is helping. 5th, they have come to meet the principal. And in this way, we have finished all the 12 filling the blanks. Can you see here, student? Just write out only the numbers on the top. Afterwards, you can complete it. Now, exercise G is also very easy. Make it as a homework. What they have told? You have to pick out 8 verbs from this word grid. Can you see here word grid? Yes. Now, for example, here is it. Talk. Talk is what? Action words. Okay, like this, how many you have to find out? 8. It is there in this. So just take a scale and just make it a box for this. Understood? So make this also as a homework for you. So in this way, we have finished whatever we have learned today. So what homework I have given you, students? Whatever, I think exercise D, 6, 7 to 12 you have to do. Then exercise F, you have to just copy it and whatever number we have given in that blanks, and that is exercise G I have given. That also you have to complete. And I hope that you have understood what we have learned in this exercise, in this lesson 15. Do you want to see the animation part of this lesson, students? Yes, we will just see the animation part.
Chapter 15. First, read the sentences in Mia. Mia goes to school every day. Birds fly in the sky. Babies cry when they are hungry. The words goes, fly, and cry are doing words. They tell what Mia, birds, and babies do. They are called birds. The word which tells us what a person, animal or thing does is known as a doing word or verb. Am is are. Read these sentences. 1. I am a dancer. 2. The dog is very active. 3. The chairs are new. The words am, is, and are tell us what I am or the dog is or what the chairs are. They do not tell us what I, the dog, and the chair are doing. An, is, and are also called verbs. Other similar verbs are was, were, shall be, will be, and so on. Verbs also tell us what a person, animal, or thing is. Has, had. Read the sentences. One, Mona has a new pen. Two, we have a new pet. The words has and have tell us what Mona and we have or possess. They do not tell us what Mona and we are doing. Has, have are also called verbs. Had is another verb of the same type. Verbs also tell us what a person, animal or thing has or possesses. We have learned about verbs which have only one word. Now, let us read some sentences where the verb is made of more than one word. Read the sentences. 1. Annie is playing in the park. Verb is playing, made up of two words. 2. The train will be reaching the station at 4 p.m. Verb will be reaching, made up of three words.
And in this way, we have finished with our today's lesson. Thank you. Have a good day.